All of you, in the previous class we have discussed some questions of board examination of your chapter ablation and derivative. Now today we will discuss some other question of chapter integral. Let's see some questions which we are taking. First question is y is equal to 0 to pi x tan x divided by sec x plus tan x dx. Okay, now we will apply here the property 0 to a fx dx is equal to 0 to a f a minus x dx. So we write what 0 to pi minus x tan pi minus x divided by sec pi minus x plus tan pi minus x dx. This is equal to, now we will write the formula pi minus x. So we write what tan pi minus x. Tan pi minus x is minus. So write 0 to pi minus x minus tan x sec pi minus x minus sec x tan pi minus x minus tan x dx. So we write 0 to pi minus x tan x divided by sec x plus tan x dx. Now I is equal to, we write 0 to pi tan x minus x tan x divided by sec x plus tan x dx. Now this is our equation first. Now we add these both. So we write 2i is equal to 0 to pi x tan x plus pi tan x minus x tan x divided by sec x plus tan x. Now this and this will cancel. We get 2i is equal to 0 to pi tan x by sec x plus tan x and dx. Okay, we get this. Now what we will do, we will take I is equal to pi by 2 and this is 0 to pi. We multiply tan x sec x minus tan x and in denominator sec x plus tan x. Okay, we get what? Sec x minus tan x dx. So I is equal to pi by 2, 0 to pi. We write sec x tan x minus tan square x divided by sec square x minus tan square x dx. And this is identity. Now we write, we will separate this both and we write I is equal to pi by 2, 0 to pi, and this is sec x tan x minus, this will be 1, this will be equal to 1, and here we write this is minus, this is pi by 2, taking outside, we write sec square minus x, sec square x प्लस वन डिजिट्स
आफ्टर मल्टीप्लाई विथ नेगेटिव साइन वी गेट
पाई बाई टू एंड दिस इज सेक एक्स विच इज जीरो टू पाई माइनस टेन एक्स विच इज जीरो टू पाई एंड दिस इज एक्स विच इज जीरो टू पाई. नाउ आफ्टर सॉल्विंग वी गेट सिक्स पाई माइनस सिक्स जीरो माइनस टेन पाई माइनस टेन जीरो एंड प्लस
ओके वी गेट फाइव माइनस जीरो. आफ्टर सॉल्विंग इट वी गेट टू वाई इज इक्वल टू the solving we get I is equal to
pi by 2 minus pi minus 2.
Okay, it will be our answer. So what we have done, we have to give 0 to pi x 10x sec x plus 10x dx. Now 0 to pi, this is pi minus x 10 pi minus x sec pi minus x plus 10 pi minus x dx. Now 0 to pi, pi minus x, this is minus 10x minus sec x minus 10x 0 to pi, and this will be taking minus outside from denominator and numerator, it will be removed and we get pi minus x 10x sec x plus 10x 0 to pi, pi 10x minus x 10x sec x plus 10x dx. So 2i is equal to 0 to pi and it will be cancelled. We get pi sec x plus 10x. Now 2i is this. So we write I is equal to pi by 2. So 0 to pi, we multiply both sides with sec x minus 10x. Sec x plus 10x. Sec x minus 10x. In numerator and denominator, our denominator will be 1. Now this, right, this is sec x 10x and this is sec x square x minus 1. So we get pi by 2 sec x 0 to pi limit tan x 0 to pi x 0 to pi. Now we write sec pi minus sec 0 10 pi minus tan 0 and pi minus 0. After putting the value of this we get I is equal to pi by 2 pi minus 2. It will be our result. Now we will see the next question. Next question is
fx is equal to 0 to
pi by 2
tan x plus cot x dx.
Now what we will do, we will change it in sin x and cos x. Okay, now we will make it, we write 0 to pi by 2, this is sin x by cos x and this is cos x by sin x dx. Okay, now taking LCM we get 0 to pi by 2, we get LCM under root cos x sin x, we get sin x plus cos x dx. Okay, now we will multiply 0 to pi by 2, we write sin x plus cos x by, here we write 2 sin x cos x, and multiply this again 2, and here we write root 2, we get 0 to pi by 2 root 2, and this we will write what, 1 minus sin x minus cos x whole square. Now here from here you see sin x minus cos x whole square is equal to 1 minus sin 2x, either we can write 2 sin x cos x. So this is equal to what? 1 minus sin x minus cos x whole square. This is equal to 2 sin x cos x. So we write at the place of this is equal to this here, and we get what we get, sin x plus cos x by under root 1 minus sin x plus cos x whole square. Okay, now we will take sin x minus cos x is equal to t, and we will differentiate it, and we will change our limit. So sin x, let sin x minus cos x is equal to t, so it will be cos x plus sin x dx is equal to dt. So this is dx, this is dx. So we write under root 0 to, so if we are putting here 0, so it will be 0, cos 0 is minus 1, so the lower limit is minus 1, and we are putting pi by 2, so it 1, and it is 0, so even 1 we are getting, and t, so it will be dt, and 1 by under root 1 minus t square, we will get this. Now minus 1 to 1 dt by under root 1 minus t square, and root 2, this is what, sin inverse t, which is limit from minus 1 to 1, we write this. Okay, so this is what, this is our nothing but sin inverse t from minus 1 to 1 plus c, so this will not be c, and we write sin inverse 1 minus sin inverse minus 1 root 2. Now this is pi by 2, and the Wellington will be what? So we can write this also sin inverse minus 1, and sin inverse minus theta is minus sin inverse theta. So we write plus sin inverse 1. So root 2 into 2 sin inverse 1. So root 2 into 2. This is pi by 2. So it will be root 2 pi. It will be your answer. Okay. So what we have done, fx is equal to 0 to pi by 2 root tan x plus under root tan x dx, 0 to pi by 2 under root sin x by cos x plus under root cos x by sin x dx, 0 to pi by 2 sin x plus cos x, taking LCM we get under root cos x sin x dx root 2, 0 to pi by 2 sin x plus cos x under root, we are multiplying pi root 2 here and root 2 here, so root 2, 0 to pi by 2, it will be sin x plus cos x, and here we write 1 minus sin x minus cos x whole square. Let sin x minus cos x is equal to t, cos x plus sin x dx is equal to dt, so we write root 2 minus 1 to 1, we change the limit, from here we get minus 1 to 1, 1 by under root 1 minus t square dt, so root 3, root 2, and this will be sine inverse t minus 1 to 1. So we get, after putting the limit, sine inverse 1 minus sine inverse minus 1 and root 2 sine inverse 1 plus sine inverse, we write sine inverse minus theta is minus sine inverse theta. So we get 2 sine inverse 1 and it will be cancelled from this, and here this will be pi by 2 and 2 and 2 will cancel. We get root 2 pi. Okay. Now we'll see the another question. Our next question is, pi is equal to 0 to pi by 2. Sine x minus cos x by 1 plus sine x into cos x dx. Okay. I is equal to 0 to pi by 2. And sine x minus cos x by 1 plus sine x cos x. So we apply first 0 to a fx dx is equal to 0 to a fa minus x dx. So let's apply and we will add this. So we write 0 to pi by 2 sine pi by 2 minus x minus cos pi by 2 minus x divided by 1 plus sine pi by 2 minus x into cos pi by 2 minus x dx. Okay, so we get I is equal to 0 to pi by 2 cos x minus sine x divided by 1 plus cos x into sine x dx. Now we add this and this. This is 1, this is 2. Adding 1 and 2, we get 2i is equal to 0 to pi by 2 sine x minus cos x plus cos x minus sine x divided by 1 plus cos x into sin x. Now we get 2y is 0 to pi by 2. This will be cancelled. So denominator is what? Sorry, our numerator is 0 by 1 plus cos x into sin x dx. So 2y is equal to, this is 0. This implies I is equal to 0. So what we have done, our integration is 0 to pi by 2 sin x minus cos x divided by 1 plus sin x into cos x dx. So 0 to pi by 2, pi by 2 minus x minus cos pi by 2 minus x dx, 1 plus sin pi by 2 minus x into cos pi by 2 minus x dx. Okay, so I is 0 to pi by 2 cos x minus sin x, and here cos x, here sin x, adding these two. Here 2y is 0 to pi by 2 sin x minus cos x plus cos x minus sin x. It will be cancelled. So our numerator is 0. So I will be 0. Now we will see the next question. Next question is, find the integral of cos 2x minus cos 2 alpha divided by cos x minus cos alpha dx. So I is equal to, we can write the formula of cos 2 alpha, 2s.
We write what? 2 cos square x minus 1 minus 2 cos square alpha plus 1 and divided by cos x minus cos alpha dx.
Okay, we can write this. Now 1 and minus 1 will be cancelled.
So we get I is equal to 2. This is cos x minus cos alpha, cos x plus cos alpha divided by cos x minus cos alpha, and it will be what? Reduced,
and we get just cos x plus cos alpha dx.
I is equal to 2 in division of cos x plus cos alpha dx, not 2, indication of cos x is sin x, and cos alpha into x plus c, it will be our answer. So it will be 2 sin x plus 2 cos alpha x plus c. We can write this. It will be our answer. Our next question is, question number 4. I is equal to 0 to pi by 2 sin 2x log of tan x dx. We have to find integral of this. So we apply first 0 to a fx dx is equal to 0 to a f a minus x dx. Okay, so we write what? 0 to pi by 2 sine 2 pi by 2 minus x log tan pi by 2 minus x dx. This is equal to 0 to pi by 2 sin, we write pi minus x, pi minus 2x log tan 90 minus theta is cos theta. So we write cot x dx. So 0 to pi by 2. Now we write this sin pi minus theta is sin theta, and log 1 by tan x dx. So 0 to pi by 2 sin 2x into log tan x to the power minus 1 dx. We can write minus 0 to pi by 2 sin 2x into log tan x dx, and this is nothing but our 0 to pi by 2 sin 2x log tan x dx. This is 1, so this is our I. Now we put, this is our nothing but I, so we write 2i is 0, so I is equal to 0.
It will be our answer. Okay, what we have done?
I is equal to 0 to pi by 2 sine 2x log tan x dx.
This is first.
And 0 to pi by 2 sine, we are applying the formula sine 2 pi by 2 minus x log tan pi by 2 minus x dx. So 0 to pi by 2 sine pi minus 2x log cot x dx. 0 to pi by 2, it will be sine 2x log 1 by tan x dx. So pi by 2 sine 2x log tan x minus 1. And it will be negative, so it will be minus 2i, so it will be I minus I, so 2i is equal to 0, so I is equal to 0.
Now we will see the next question. We will see the next question. Next question is
integration of x sine plus x under root 1 minus x square dx. So we take sine minus x is t, it will be what? 1 by under root 1 minus x square dx is equal to dt. So we write x is equal to sine t and this is t dt. So integration is t sine t dt.
Now we apply here by part. So
this is our first function, this is second function. So we apply our first function integration of second function cos t minus integration of differentiation of first function is integration of second function cos t dt. So minus t cos t plus cos t sin t plus c now we will write minus t is sin inverse x cos t is under root 1 minus sine square x sine square t and this is sine t is x, so x square plus sine t is x plus c, so it will be what? So it will be sine x minus under root 1 minus x square sine plus x plus c, so it will be our integration. If we have to given I is equal to integration of x sine inverse x under root 1 minus x square dx, so we have taken this is t, so we write sine t is equal to x, now differentiate it, we write 1 by under root 1 minus x square dx is equal to dt. So we write here what we will write here, this is sine inverse, this 1 by under root 1 minus x square dx is dt and sine inverse x is t and this x is, x will be equal to sine t. So here we apply by parts, this is first function, this is second function. First function integration of second function minus integration of differentiation of first function is 1. Integration of second function is minus cos t, so it minus minus plus and here is minus t, so we write minus t cos t, here sine t plus c and t is minus sine inverse x, cos t can be written as 1 minus sine square t and sine t is what x. So we write under root 1 minus x square plus and this sin t is x. So we can write x minus under root 1 minus x square sin inverse x. Okay, plus c. It will be our answer. Okay, in this way we can integrate this
इंटीग्रल. ओके, थैंक यू.